Good evening. I have certainly a hot topic to talk about this evening, and one in which that has gained some steam as a result of a meeting at the Bureau of Engraving and Printing in Washington, D.C. As some of you probably didn't know or may know, the Bureau of Engraving and Printing used to have an online store where you could purchase collectible sets of banknotes and various presentations. Sometimes they'd be mated up with a special coin from the U.S. Mint. Well, the BEP has decided to shut that down, and they have collaborated with the U.S. Mint in making future products to be sold on the U.S. Mint's website, which is fantastic. It's nice to see a collaboration, one in which they'll combine paper money and actual physical coins in a smattering of a really nice suite, I guess, of various products to be offered from this point forward. Okay, but that's not the big news. On October 17th, there was an event at the BEP, okay, called the Numismatic Forum, all right? One of the guests who was in attendance and had the opportunity to speak at the event is David Ryder. He's the Mint Director of the U.S. Mint. And he talked about a few things about, you know, how would the overall makeup of the new BEP U.S. Mint collaboration would go as far as future product offerings. So that was in there. There was also an emphasis on numismatics for youth. Okay, so there's a separate program going on here on the side for that. But the big one that was talked about for probably a short second, okay, if you weren't paying attention, you would miss it. There was a lot of buzz surrounding what could be probably one of the biggest events in U.S. coin collecting, and that's the release of an exclusive low mintage rare coin in general circulation. Yes, you heard that right. I would say that this is, bar none, by far and away, the biggest numismatic U.S. Mint event since the State Quarter Program. And I think it is 100 times better than that. So the opportunities are endless in this program. The director, Mr. Ryder, did not make any information known as in terms of the denomination, whether this specific coin is it be crafted in silver, gold, platinum, the new palladium offering, or another clad or copper choice. None of that was ever discussed. There's no discussion of mintage. There's also no discussion of how the coin would be introduced into general circulation. Yeah, it leaves a lot of information, but it's probably a good thing for the mere fact that this program needs a lot of seclusion of information in order for it to be a huge success. So the less we know, the better. The better in terms of the overall rarity and value of said piece. Now, we could be thinking all day long, well, what are they going to do? Are they going to release a 90% silver dime, okay? That's going to be a West Point variety, a la 1996 W, all right? What if they only mint 10,000 pieces? Can you imagine how much these coins would fetch for in the secondary market? It would be an ultimate, absolute feeding frenzy. And I would venture to guess that this project, okay, will take the combined forces of both the Philadelphia Mint and the Denver Mint, since they service the entire country for all of its coinage needs. Okay, you can't very well do a program like this where it's only going to be targeted at the Philadelphia Mint, and everybody east of the Mississippi will benefit of this program. Okay, this is going to be a nationwide event, and this is going to happen in 2019. Okay, this is going to be incredible. It's going to be an ultimate feeding frenzy. Not only that, but this is going to be a huge, huge event for the U.S. Mint, for their secondary sales and their online services. This should be a big deal. But I just wanted to let everybody know that this was talked about not even 2 weeks ago, and this is looking like a possibility for 2019, okay? And then we're talking about an exclusive low mintage numismatic rarity is set to be released into general circulation. That's it. There's really not a whole lot else I could tell you until we begin to see. Maybe there might be more information, but they're really keeping this a tight-lipped situation. And again, I think it's a great idea that they keep this heavily guarded, this information, and they keep it under wraps. Okay, I think once we go into the 2019 season and these coins are released, it's going to be a mad dash to find out, you know, what's different from all these coins. Will they release a gold coin? That's going to be a huge deal. A gold Lincoln cent in circulation is going to be absolutely bonkers for the hobby, number one, the hobby, and number two, for the secondary market. It's going to be a wave of excitement. But you know what? I wanted to bring this to your guys' attention that this is indeed going to happen. There is no additional information that's known at this time, and you know, we'll see what happens. It sounds like it's going to be a lot of fun, and you know, everybody is going to be, you know, very much in tune, and this will make it into the airwaves. It's going to be on TV. You're going to see it all over the internet. All the news outlets are going to be covering this. It's going to be crazy. Okay, huge. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this content this evening. Hope you guys had a wonderful weekend. All right, the weekend can't be short enough, right? But if you like today's content, hit the like button. And as always, I am Blue Ridge Silverhound. Subscribe to me if you haven't, and I'll talk to you guys soon. I'll talk to you guys Monday, and it's Monday for some of you already. But anyways, you guys have a pleasant evening/morning, and I'll see you soon. Take care.